Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world of Wayne. We're now going to be doing box 10 of the Agora Models release, and build the Jaguar E-Type. You know what, looking back at some of the photos that I took last year, I actually visited Jaguar Classic in Coventry and I got to ride in the car that this is modeled on, and I'll put some pictures up on the screen here, and actually seeing some of the details that we've had to do in this stage, and one of them I've already done, which is the tire, and then matching it off with the tire, which I also took a picture that you see here. It does bring back a lot of memories, but we're gonna get cracking on this today. If you want to get this for yourself, I have put the link down here to the Agora Models website. You can get this all the way from pack one, but without further ado, let's get cracking. Okay, the whole of this build is going to require me to have my part work upgrades mat down, because we're going to be working with the bonnet that we were working on in the last pack. And that looks just like that there. I'll show you on the side camera. Pretty impressive. Okay, I'm going to put that to one side. And this is what we get in stage 74. We've got a valance, which is going inside the bonnet. We've got a lens and a surround for the headlight. We've got this little detail here. We've got a couple of bags of screws. And it's that little tiny detail that looks like that that we're going to be installing first. I want to make sure we put this round the right way. So it's actually going to fit on like that there. If you can see that. Drop this in a bit of oil because this is going into metal. Just put one in loose, put the other one in, and then I'll tighten these up. Don't put these in too tight, otherwise you're going to split the plastic. But there we go, that's like that. Now we're going to put the valance in, moving just the headlight wires out the way. This is going to go into the three holes that we can just see there. So that's going to go on like that, and that's held in with the AM15 screws. Silver screws again, and there's three of these to put in. And here's the third one going in here. Make that nice and tight. Excellent. Now, I'm going to keep this plastic tray that the lenses are coming in. I'm just going to pop the lens and the frame out. Don't really want to touch this because I don't want to get fingerprints on it. But I do want this section here, the plastic tray, because I'm going to need some glue. And we're going to be taking the lens. Whoops, dropping things. Taking the lens, and we're going to be putting that in the inside here, so it looks just like that. But we need to put just a channel of glue just around the outside. Now you really just want to spot this in just around the lug holes. You can see holes there. Now I'm very reluctant to use super glue on this, because if you put super glue on this, it will start to cloud the clear plastic there. So what I'm using is a little bit of micro crystal clear. Now this does take a lot longer to set, but you'll thank me at the end of the day, because it will keep things clear, and we're not going to have any smoking on that lens. So I didn't use a lot of glue there, so I'm putting this in, pushing that over the holes, both sides. Perfect. So that now looks like that. Turn over the bonnet here, and it's this side that we're going to be putting this in, and I'm going to put this into place. So what I've done is I've put two tabs in. I've got one more just to slip in on this side, and there we go, that fits in perfectly like that. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now, stage 5 is an exact mirror of what we've just done, except this time, just get that frame out, we have a heat air intake here. So that air intake is going to go onto the lip section of the valance there. As you see, it's got a hook over. We can push that in. That will hold itself in so it looks like that. And then we're going to be putting this valance into the car, just like we did last time, moving the wires out the way. And that's going to go in like that. Once again, held in with the AM15 screws. This is the last one going in. Looking good. Excellent. Let's turn that over so you can see how that's looking. Now I'm just going to take the lens, but before I put that in, I'm just going to once again just dop a little bit of micro crystal clear into the lugs. So, 1, 2, this does dry very clear, and it's just enough to keep this into place for when we actually attach this to the car. And again, I've tried to do this without touching anything. So there we go, that's another lens in. And then to put this in, I'm just going to bring this around here, and the easiest way to put it in, put the tab in at the front, then the one at the side, and then just clip the one in here like that. And there we go, that's sitting beautifully, and that's both of those headlights in place. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 76, we've got the stone guard here with this lovely metal mesh frame that we're going to be putting into these points here. As you can see, we've got some holes for this to be screwed into. So that's going to go in like that. We're going to screw that in with these AG01 silver screws. These are tiny, but they're going in beautifully with a PHO screwdriver. You would think these screwdrivers are a little bit too big for these screws, but I do find they're probably the most versatile that we've got. They can handle the bigger screws and these little tiny ones that you see here. So one more screw just to put in. So I'm going to turn over the bonnet again. And this time, as you see, we've got two brackets here. We're going to be putting those brackets this way round so they fit over the two lugs that we can see just there. This is going to slot into the gap, so it sort of holds itself there. And that's going to be held in with two of the flanged screws, which are AM10. We want to make sure that these tabs at the side go either side of that post. So I'm having to just readjust that for a second so it can't move backwards and forwards there. But I will get these flange screws in. That's one, and that one's two. And there we go. Once again, that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 77, we have the front underpanel, and this again is a lovely piece of metal, perfectly painted there. I love that. That's just going to go into the holes that we can see at the side this way round, and it's these little points here which are connecting to those holes. So let me line them up, one in this side and one in this side here, just like that. Perfect. Now in the points at the back here, which you can see on the top camera, I'm going to be putting some AM15 screws, and as I put this down, I want to make sure the wires are actually trailed. I'll get one in inside that cavity gap just there. Let's do the other side. And then just in the front here, we're going to be putting AM11 screws. So one that side and just one on the other side here. And that looks excellent. Check that out. Check that out on the side camera from behind. And that's what the front looks like. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Okay, so from stages 78 to 81, we're going to be creating another rim with the tire. And as you can see, I've already done that. Now, if you want to see how I create these tires, I have put a couple of videos at the end of this playlist, and I'll put the link to the playlist up here, and you can watch how I put these tires together. Which means at the end of 81, all I have to do now is attach this to the vehicle. So as you can see, we've already got one tire on this, and all we're going to do is put the other tire on. That's just going to go on here. We've got some little tabs in there that we do need to match up to make sure this sits flat. So I'm just rotating this around to where it goes. And you know you've got them in because it should turn the whole hub carry around. That's perfect. We are good there. Take a washer and one of these tiny screws here, and I'm going to screw this onto the hub. I want that to go in nice and tight. I don't want any wobble in this wheel. That's perfect. And there we go. We've got both wheels on the car. And that's all there is to do in those stages. Which means the last thing we're working on is the boot lid. That looks like this. So let's get this open. Check that out, look, with the Jaguar insignia there. That looks excellent. Okay, so putting it this way around, we've got these brackets to put in. Now, these are metal, just so you know, and they're going to go this way around. So we've got one this side and one this side so that these points are pointing inwards. They're going to be held in with some AM18 screws. So I'll just put one in each side just to hold them in, just so you can see how they are laid out here. They are labeled L&R, just so you know, but it's pretty easy to see how they go. There you go. And then what I'll do is I'll get the other two screws into place. Now we've got the boot catch, which looks like that. That's going to go in the front. It is orientated, so it goes around that way there. That's going to be held in with AM09 screws. One there, and one the other side there. And we want to keep these two parts safe for next time, because that is all there is to do in that stage, and that's all there is to do in that pack. You know what, having the tire finished was probably the most fun in that pack, because that was the fifth tire we've done, fifth wheel we've done. We don't have to do any more. And if I've learned something, when I started doing the wheels, I was a novice, I didn't know what I was doing, but by the fifth wheel, I think I had it down to a T. I think I managed to do the whole thing in about 20 minutes, so not too bad, just need a steady hand. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, once again, I have put the link down here to the Agora Models website. You can get this all the way from pack one, but I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.